Welcome to Honest News. So the real reason behind the 5G technology, I believe, is in this video. Up till now, or at least up till the time of the making of this video, this has all been kept secret. But the government's been working tirelessly to put together the eye in the sky, or Big Brother, where they have the capability of watching everything that goes on this planet. And I think this video is pretty telling of that. So let's take a look.
This is the next generation of surveillance. For the first time, we actually have permission from the government to show the basic capabilities. It is important for the public to know that some of these capabilities exist.
Engineer Yanis Antoniadis designed the new sensor known as Argus. With 1.8 billion pixels, it's the world's highest resolution camera. Argus fits inside this pod that attaches to the belly of a UAV. But because much of the work is classified, we can't see the sensor itself.
Because we are not allowed to expose some of the pieces that make up the sensor, so you get to look at pretty plastic curtains.
Also known as wide area persistent stare, Argus is the equivalent of having up to 100 predators look at an area the size of a medium-sized city at once. This image was taken 17,500 feet above Quantico, Virginia, and covers 15 square miles.
This whole image is at a very, very fine resolution. So if we wanted to know what is going on in any spot along this image, say near this building at this intersection, we can generate a moving image that shows what's going on in the area.
Simply by touching the screen, Antoniadis has opened up a window showing a detailed area while still maintaining the broader context.
And everything that is a moving object is being automatically tracked. The color boxes represent that the computer has recognized the moving objects. You can see individuals crossing the street. You can see individuals walking in parking lots. There's actually enough resolution to be able to see the people waving their arms or walking around, what kind of clothes they wear. And you could pick the location of where you produce these images anywhere in the entire field of view.
Antoniadis can open up to 65 windows at once and can see objects as small as 6 inches on the ground.
From even 17,500 feet, the white thing that you see flying around is a bird.
Argus streams live to the ground and also stores everything. 1 million terabytes of video a day, which is the equivalent of 5,000 hours of high-definition footage.
So you can go back and say, I would like to see what happened at this particular location 3 days, 2 hours, 4 minutes ago, and it would actually show you exactly what happened as if you were watching it live.
To create the world's highest-definition camera, Antoniadis needed to design a new imaging chip. But DARPA, the project's funder, wanted to move fast and keep costs down. So he borrowed technology that most people have in their pockets.
Inside this cell phone, we find a tiny little camera. So if you were to take off the majority of it, you'd be left with an imaging chip. If you were to take 368 of these and make a big mosaic out of them and start shooting images, now you have Argus.
Unlike the Predator camera that limits field of view, Argus melds together video from each of its 368 chips to create a 1.8 billion pixel video stream. This makes it possible to zoom in and still see tremendous detail. Whether Argus has been deployed in the field is classified.
I'm not at liberty to discuss plans with the government, but if we had our choice, we would like Argus to be over the same area 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. That's not very easily achievable with manned platforms. This is where UAVs come in, and they're absolutely the perfect platform.
Argus may be mounted on an armed UAV like the Predator, a long-range platform like the giant Global Hawk, or a development craft called the Solar Eagle that may someday stay aloft for years at a time.
The U.S. Air Force right now has the ability to archive every single video that comes off of every single UAV. We're moving to an increasingly electronic society where our movements are going to be tracked.
Interesting. So it looks like they need 5G to make this work. Now, I believe that I really do believe that this technology is going to be used by the Beast system. That they will be able to actually zoom in. And this was, you know, this was years ago that this technology was available. Where are they now? You know, the scripture says that it says knowledge shall be increased. For the prophecy of scripture to be fulfilled, they have to have this kind of technology in place. And think about this. The scripture says the two witnesses that will lie in the street all night, I guess it's for 3 days, they'll lie in the street and then they will be raised up. But it says everyone's going to see them all at the same time. How is that possible? How is everybody going to see, everybody on the earth is going to be able to see this all at the same time? There's only one way they could do that. There would have to be technology in place for that to happen. And again, this was years ago that they had the technology to zoom in on a certain area and actually have video footage. I mean, this is real time from the eye in the sky. Hello, folks, this is the eye in the sky. Now, when you take this, okay, and you go to the video, pictures, you can do a search yourself, go on Google, and look up the pyramid with the eye and the United States government. Obviously, it's on the dollar bill. So, you know, it's all there. The purpose of the eye has always been the same. It's never not been the plan. It's always been the plan. And that is total surveillance of the world, of the whole globe. But it'd be interesting for you probably to know, it's not man that's trying to develop this technology or trying to put this together. It's the prince and power of the air. It's Satan. He can't be in every place at the same time. He's not omnipresent. He's not all-knowing like God is. And so he's putting all this technology into place so that he can have total control. It's not flesh and blood, people. This is Satan at work, okay? And so this, again, was years ago. I don't mean to be repetitious, but this was years ago that they had this technology that they were keeping secret from the public. But now, where are they? That they could see from that far up, they can see. I believe they have the technology from satellites, not just from, you know, something flying in the regular, you know, in the sky. Some craft in the sky. But I think that they're actually going to use satellites to do this. And when you start putting all this together and you realize that Islam, that Allah, and you, as I've been doing, sharing with you how it's all coming together, and you understand the pyramid, the eye, the technology, you're putting it all together. This, without question, the Eye of Horus, whatever you want to call it, this is all the process, the preparation for the beast system. Okay? This will work with 5G, and maybe before it's all said and done, they may go 6G or 7G. I don't know what they're willing to do. I mean, 5G is going to be destructive in itself as far as for human life. But how far are they willing to go so that they can keep an eye on you? Are you listening? Their whole plan is total domination, total control. That's what they're after. That's their plan. And you may say, oh, that sounds too simple. No, it's not really. If you understand, it's actually very complicated. The simplicity in all of it is their end goal, the end game. They want to be God. Hello? They want to play God. They want to be God. And Satan's going to allow it. But he's the one that's the God of this world. He's using them to get what he wants. Hello? I said he's using them to get what he wants. He doesn't care what they want. He'll give them what they want. He'll give them their trinkets. He'll give them their illusion. But what he gets out of it is total surveillance, total control. He knows everything that's going on the planet at all times. Remember, I'm going to say this again. Satan is not all-knowing. He is not omnipresent. He's not omniscient. He can't be in all places at the same time. He can only be in one place at one time. But with this technology, he can be in more than one place at a time.